Hello students, this is Vitthal Anuvat. Today we are going to learn about the relationship with neighboring countries of India. First neighbor of India is Afghanistan. India's relationship with Afghanistan are healthy and there is a cooperation in economic, technical and cultural fields. Means India's relationship with Afghanistan is economical and technical and cultural fields are too much greater. India appealed the United Nations sponsored Geneva agreements on the Afghanistan in 1988. Then India recapped its stand for the independence non-allied Afghanistan. So it's a part of that one. India provided 10 crore assistance for the relief and rehabilitation of the Afghan refugees. And India also supporting Afghanistan in public health, small scale industry and education also. The Indo-Afghan trade stood at the $680 million during 2013-2014, which is conjecturally rising falling to the full implementation of Afghanistan and Pakistan Trade and Transit Agreement APTTA to expand the economic ties between the two nations. The Afghanistan embassy in Delhi has frequently engaged with the national and local Chamber of Commerce and Industries of India. There are many MOUs, Memorandum of Understanding has been developed between these two countries. They are concerned with the commercial backgrounds. And another 20 MOUs with the state chambers and hospitals across India, among these few are in the coming months. It can be assigned that India remains a vital part of Afghanistan's stable progress in this various field like as peace, then pluralism and prosperity. Since ancient times, the peoples of Afghanistan and India have interacted with each other through trade and commerce, peacefully coexisting on the basis of their shared culture, values and commonalities. Means there is the two great relationship between Afghanistan and India, accordingly, economically, technically, then culturally, and any other things. The second important neighbor of India is Bangladesh. Indian government believe in maintaining the good relationship with the neighboring countries is that the India's policy and this policy is part that India had recognized Bangladesh as a separate and independent state date on 6 December 1971. India fought together with the Bangladeshis to liberate Bangladesh from West Pakistan in 1971. Then Bangladesh and India share a common traditions. They are pleasant and both nations make the great efforts to solve the problem of waters of Ganga at Farakka and Tin Bega corridor in spirit of give and take. India has helped the Bangladesh in the recovery of cyclone victims in 1985. Bangladesh relation with India has been difficult in terms of irrigation and land border disputes post 1976. At the beginning of India's relationship with Bangladesh have not been stronger because of the India's absolute support for the independence and opposition against Pakistan in 1971. Most important relationship between the India and Bangladesh has been concerned here that there are the small pieces of land along the border region that Bangladesh is tactfully trying to reclaim. The Padua part of Sylhet division before 1971 has been under Indian control since the war in 1971. 1871. This small strips of land was reoccupied by the BDR in 2001, but later given back to the India after Bangladesh government decided to solve this problem through diplomatic negotiations. India estimates that over 20 million Bangladeshis are living unlawfully in India since 2002. Means this is a recent issue is has been emerged. The Rohingya Muslims, they are live in India unlawfully. India has been building an India Bangladesh fence along much of the 2500 miles border. Bangladesh also offer India transit route to travel through Bangladesh to its northeast states, and India and Bangladesh also have a free trade agreement in June 7, 2015. Both nations solved its border dispute on June 6, 2015. The third important neighbor of India is Bhutan. Relationship between the India and Bhutan are friendly since past and it's strengthened recently. India has helped Bhutan in industry development such as in the field of telecommunications, hydro survey, education and forestry. The Indo-Bhutan friendship treaty was substantially revised under the Bhutanese King Jigme Khesar Nagmel Wangchuk, whereas his treaty was happened in 1949. The Indo-Bhutan Friendship Treaty of 2007 supports the Bhutan position as an independent and sovereign nation. Then the hydropower sector is one of the most important sector of the Bhutan. Is the support of bilateral corporations of India. It demonstrates the mutually beneficial synergy by the providing clean energy to the India, export revenue to Bhutan. Bhutan's hydroelectricity in that the 14% contribution to the Bhutanese electricity. Means their GDP is 40% has been sharing due to the India, and about 35% of Bhutan's total export. Means Bhutan mostly export the electricity to the world, means to the India and surrounding around country of this country. Three hydroelectric projects totaling 1416 megawatts in that Chukha, HEP is a 60 megawatts, and Kirichu HEP and 1020 megawatts Tala. Some important hydroelectric projects are already exporting electric to India. It is assessed that India continuously involves the business relationships or the relations and development partner of Bhutan. Burma or the Myanmar is an important neighbor of India. The India maintained political relation after the Burma's independence from Great Britain in 1948. Burma is located in the south of state of Mizoram, Manipur, Nagaland and Arunachal Pradesh in northeast India. Since many years, Indo-Burmese relation were strong due to the cultural links, prosperous commerce, common interest in regional affairs and the presence of significant Indian community in Burma. And Burma is one of the good neighbor with the whose India share a long and sensitive border. That's the most important thing is here. The relationship between the Burma and India is friendly, means comparatively to other countries. When the serious turbulence erupted in Burma in 1988, India expressed the sympathy for the democratic aspirations for the people in that country. In 2001, the Indian Army completed the construction of major roads along its border with Burma. And India has also been building major roads, highways, ports and pipelines within Burma to increase its influence in the region and its counter-China rising stride at the Indo-China Peninsula. And India's major purchaser is Burma, is oil and gas. In 2007, India export to Burma totally $185 US, while the import from Burma were estimated $810 million, consisting mostly of oil and gas. China is an important neighbor of India, and we know there are the too much conflicts has been started with China, but the relationship with the India and China is too changeable. Though it's observed that India has traditionally friendly relations, in 1962 the India invaded India and occupied a huge area. After that, the relation between these two countries has been strained. India always make efforts to improve relation with the China. India wants good solution of the boundary issue, but China wants to delay solution to the border issue. With respect to the boundaries disagreement, India has clear positions. In spite of presenting suspicious remaining from the 1962 Sino-Indian War and continuing boundary disputes over the Askai Chin and Arunachal Pradesh, Sino-Indian relations have improved progressively since 1988. Both countries have sought to reduce the tension along each other's frontiers. In the both nations have high level delegates and minister regularly visit. Such efforts have helped to improve the relationship between these two countries. In December 1996, PRC President Jiang Zemin visited to the India during the tour of South Asia. While in New Delhi, he signed that the Indian Prime Minister has a serious confidence building measures for the disputed boundaries or the frontiers or the borders. Since 2004, the economic growth of China and India also hit the friends closer relation, and India's and the China's trade also one important part between these two countries, and it's $65.47 billion in 2013-14. The growing economic relationship between these two countries is too important for both of countries. They have also worked together several issues ranging from World Trade Organization's Doha Round 2008, the Regional Free Trade Agreements, like Indo-US nuclear deal. India and China have also agreed to cooperate in the field of civilian nuclear energy. Recently, India and China relations are not much good on the Pangong region. The next important neighbor of India is Maldives. It is a retained cordial relationship with this Maldives. India and Maldives share ethics, linguistic, cultural and religious commercial links. India troops land in Mole in November 1988 and save Maldivian hostage who has been detained in the COF. And as a part of SAARC, as a founder of SAARC India, the South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation, which bring the together Afghanistan, Bangladesh, Bhutan, India and Maldives, also one important country of this SAARC nation. India and Maldives signed a trade agreement in 1981, which is provided the export of vital commodities. Then Nepal, India is also one important neighbor of India, and relationship with these two countries has nowadays some disturbed. But before that, the India's and Nepal's relation is too good comparatively another countries. As being part of that one, there is no any visa during these two country, Nepal and India. That's part of that one. Nepal became during 1989 when the India imposed at the 30-month long economic barrier of Nepal. But Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi, whenever they meet to the Nepal, after that they solve this problem. Him devastating earthquake occurred in Nepal on 25 April 2015. The government of India swiftly dispatched National Disaster Response Force (NDRF) team's special aircraft with the rescue and relief materials to the Nepal. In 2015, the blockades of the Indian and Nepal's border has affected the relationship with these two countries. India and Nepal has a strong economic ties also. Since 1996, Nepal export to India have grown rapidly and bilateral trade more than 7 times. The main item of the export from India to Nepal are petroleum products. India has also helped Nepal in the field of education and proved to the best neighbor. In cultural arena, the government of India initiatives to promote people to the people contacts in the area of art and culture. He is one important neighbor of India is Pakistan. As we know, what is the relationship between the India and Pakistan from the conflict between these two countries has been started from 14 August 1947. The Pakistan has been antagonistic way in the maintaining the relation with the India, but India has made extreme effort to improve the and stabilize the relationship with Pakistan. Though there are the historical, cultural and ethics links between these two countries, and has been affected by years of the dispute ever since the partitions of India in 1947. Major cause of dispute between these two countries is Kashmir. After the invasion of Pakistan, tribesmen and Pakistani parliamentary force, the Hindu Maharaja of the Dogra Kingdom of Jammu and Kashmir, Hari Singh. We know the story what is happened into the 1947 and 1948 into the Kashmir, the Hari Singh and the people of Jammu and Kashmir. And its Muslim Prime Minister Sheikh Abdullah signed its instrument of the association with the New Delhi. The first Kashmir war started after the Indian Army entered Srinagar, the capital of the state, secured with the area from the occupying forces. The war ended in December 1948. We know this is a great story within this this story of Sardar Patel, how to Kashmir has been merged into the India. The first Kashmir war started, we know, in 1949, and the Indo-Pakistan war has been happened into the 1964. In this war, India defeated the Pakistan. Then in 1971 also, India and Pakistan went into the war again, and once again the Pakistan has defeated, and in that time this is the conflict being over East Pakistan. This is a large scale atrocities committed. There has been Pakistan army led to militants of the Bengali refugees. Then in 1998, the India performed the Pokhran nuclear test. in the administration of our Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee. The following are the Lahore Declaration in February 1999. The relationship between these two nations slightly improved. In 2008, Mumbai assault seriously destabilized the relationship between these two countries, and nowadays the India and Pakistan relation is not much good, or they are totally destructed with each other. And last important neighbor of India is Sri Lanka. The relationship between this Sri Lanka and India is too much improved, but the liberal of Tamil Tiger Illam means Litte, due to this important agencies or the terrorist activities has been happening to this Sri Lanka, the relation has been destroyed with these two countries due to the that one in 1987. Through the bilateral relationship between the Sri Lanka and India have been generally pleasant, but were affected by the Sri Lankan civil war and by the failure of Indian intervention during the civil war as the India support from Tamil Tiger militants. Then political relations are too close within these two countries. Then political relations are built through the high-level exchange visit for Professor G.L.P. Ace, Minister of External Affairs of the Sri Lanka. Then there is the agreement within the Sri Lanka on policy on the importance of Indian in Sri Lanka external relation matrix. Sri Lanka has supported India's continuation into the Parliament member of the United Nations Security Council. The permanent membership is being the most important part for the India, and there are many countries is support to India in that. The Sri Lanka also one important neighboring country. China is not in favor of India. The India and Sri Lanka has also closed the commercial relationships, and India's and Sri Lanka's are the largest trade partner in Southeast Asia. The coffee, tea, such are the most important things used for the trade. Thank you. Thank you very much.